Okay, so in this video, we're going to take a look at questions involving probability scales. So first of all, a probability scale is a number line from 0 to 1 on which we can place the probability of a specific event occurring. So we sometimes do this with decimal amounts, but we most commonly use fractions. So these events can range from a probability of 0, which we call impossible, all the way up to a probability of 1, which we call certain. We then have our fraction of 1/2 in the middle, which we call even probability. So as we come down the scale from even to impossible, we start to get probabilities that are increasingly unlikely. And on the other side of the scale, when we go from even to certain, we start to get probabilities that are increasingly likely. So we can also split our scale further into quarters. So we've got our 1/2 in the middle, which is equivalent to 2/4. So either side of that, we have 1/4 and 3/4. And then we generally use these values to interpret likeliness of an event happening by expressing 1/4 as unlikely and then 3/4 as likely. So let's take a look at a few questions. So for this first question, we have that a fair four-sided spinner is spun. And for part A, on the probability scale, we want to mark with a cross the probability that the spinner lands on B. So it says in the question that it's a fair spinner, so that we know all the individual outcomes have equal probability. So now we just want to look for the probability of the spinner landing on B. So we're going to express this as a fraction. We're going to look for the number of successful outcomes out of the total number of outcomes. So for our numerator for our fraction, we want to look for how many B's there are. Well, there's only one B on the spinner. So that is our numerator. And then for the denominator, we want to put the total number of outcomes. Well, it's a four-sided spinner. We have 4 total possible outcomes, so that's going to go on the denominator. So the probability of the spinner landing on B is 1/4. So we now need to mark that on the probability scale. So a quarter is going to sit right in the middle between 0 and 1/2. So my x would go here. For part B to the question, we now want to write down the probability that the spinner lands on C. So we're looking for the probability of C. So we're going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to look for the number of successful outcomes. So how many C's are on the spinner? We have 1 here, 2 here. So we have 2 successful outcomes. And we're going to put that over the total number of outcomes, which we know is 4. So the probability of the spinner landing on C is 2/4, but then we can simplify that to 1/2. And that would be the answer to that one. Okay, for this next question, we have a fair four-sided spinner is spun. And then for part A, on the probability scale, mark with a cross the probability that the spinner lands on 3. So again, we're looking for the probability that the spinner lands on 3. So to begin with, we're looking for the number of successful outcomes. How many 3s are there on the spinner? Well, there's 1 here, 2 here. So we have 2 successful outcomes. And we want to put that over the total number of outcomes, which we know from the question is 4. So the probability of the spinner landing on 3 is 2/4. We can then simplify that to 1/2. So the probability of the spinner landing on a 3 is 1/2. We then need to mark that on the probability scale. So that's going to go here. Okay, and for part B to the question, we now want to write down the probability that the spinner lands on 4. So the probability that the spinner lands on 4. Well, looking at the spinner, we don't have any 4s. So therefore, it is impossible for the spinner to land on a 4, meaning the probability has to be 0. Because again, if we wrote it as our fraction, we'd have 0 for the number of successful events over the 4 total events. So we'd have 0 divided by 4, which is still obviously going to give us 0. So that would be the answer to that one. Okay then, so for question 3, we're told that there are 8 marbles in a bag. 4 of the marbles are red, 3 of the marbles are blue, and 1 marble is green. A marble is then picked at random. So for part A to the question, on the probability scale, we want to mark with a cross the probability that the marble is red. So to find the probability that this marble picked is red, we're going to look first for the number of successful outcomes. So how many red marbles are there in the bag? Well, we're told there are 4 red marbles, so that's going to go on my numerator. And then for my denominator, we want to put the total number of outcomes. So how many total marbles are there in the bag? Well, we're told there are 8 in total. So the probability of picking a red marble is 4/8. But then we can simplify this. We can divide the numerator and denominator both by 4. So if we do that, we have 4 divided by 4, which is 1, 8 divided by 4, which gives us 2. So 4/8 is equivalent to 1/2. So on the probability scale, mark with a cross the probability that the marble is red. We can put our cross on 1/2. So moving on to part B, on the probability scale, mark with a cross the probability that the marble is yellow. So looking back at the question, we know in our bag there are only red, blue, and green marbles. So there's no chance that we can pick a yellow marble. So because we know it's impossible, we know our probability is therefore 0. So that's going to go right at the front of our scale. And then for part C of the question, we want to write down the probability that this picked marble is blue. So to find the probability of this marble being blue, we're first going to look for the number of successful outcomes. How many blue marbles are there in the bag? Well, there are 3 blue marbles, so that's going to go on my numerator, and we're going to put that over the total number of outcomes. Well, in total, there's 8 marbles, so that's going to go on the bottom. So we've got 3/8. We can't simplify that anymore. So our final answer, the probability of the marble being blue, would be 3/8. And that's the final answer to that question. So well done if you followed along with those examples today. And that's it for this video. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.